Good morning, friends. I am Dr. Prathamesan and I am an orthopedic surgeon and specializing in sports medicine. Many sports person and athletes come to me and ask about plyometric training and whether it can be done or not. So now today, let's talk about plyometric training. Now, what is a plyometric training? I'll just give you a historical background. The plyometric training was invented by Soviet athletes way back in 1940s and 50s, in which they used to do explosive jumping exercises. So basically, plyometric exercises are jumping exercises which includes eccentric and concentric contractions of the muscle. So what they basically do is you jump and then you balance yourself and just oppose the action by re-jumping again. So you land on the ground, maintain your balance, and then you re-jump again. So this is a very, very good exercise when you talk about achieving strength and speed. So this is very good exercises when it is done for an athlete who wants a speed training. It has got a limited role in endurance sports, but it has got a very good role in sports which needs explosive performance. So let's talk about the historical aspect. So as I told you, it was invented by Soviet athletes, started by Soviet athletes, and they used to do explosive plyometrics. And by explosive plyometrics, what they mean is they were very, very small. They were doing it with very small rest time. So they will land and will give an explosive contraction or eccentric contractions to the muscles as soon as they will land down. And that will increase the contraction and increase the white muscle fibers and increase the agility and speed of your muscle fibers. Slowly, it was studied and taken up in the States as well, and it was studied. And then there was another group which developed plyometrics, which is called as a slow plyometrics, in which it is not as much explosive, but it has got its own speed. And you can do it at agile pace. So you can do it at a slow pace, but the basic principles remain the same of jumping and re-jumping. Now, many patients ask me whether it increases or decreases the chance of injury. So that is a very, very good question. So let me summarize in that way that plyometric training, while doing the training, you are at a high risk of injuring your joints. But if you do your plyometric training properly, you will have a less risk of having any sports injury while you are actually on ground. So it's a risky training while you do it, but it is a protective training for your long run, because if you are doing a plyometric training properly with a good proprioception, you will be able to compete in your sporting events with less amount of injuries. Okay, so now the question comes, what can we do to prevent injuries while we do a plyometric training? So there are three most important aspects to that. Number one, you need to increase your proprioception. Number two, you need to increase your strength. And number three, you need to increase your flexibility. So ideally, you should be able to do 50 squats at about 60% of your body weight easily before you want to start a plyometric training with a basic. So you should have that much of strength, you should have a good proprioception, and your joint should be flexible and pliable enough before you start your plyometric training. So it's not a beginner's training, but you can start it at your own pace when you develop a good strength, good flexibility, and good proprioception, and then you can start with a plyometric training. It should always be done under supervision of a qualified coach. That is very, very important, because if you are doing unsupervised plyometric exercise, you stand at a risk of injuring your joints while doing a plyometric training. Now, as I told you, the principle is learning of the muscle to shift from extension to contraction. So this is basically the principle of plyometric, in which the muscle learn to shift from extension to contraction, extension to contraction. And you must always and always land soft while doing a plyometric training. So whenever you are doing a plyometric training, you have to land soft like a cat. You land soft, and then you can either do an explosive like the Soviet athletes do. You can do explosive training, or you can do a gentle slow paced training. But then important thing is you have to land soft. Now there are different variations by which you can do a plyometric training. The basic plyometric training is just a jump squat. You can also do plyometric training like back and front jumps. You can do jump lunges, or you can do jump squats. And with the modification, you can do a height jumps. So you can do depth jumps. So you can jump from a height and then you can jump back. So this is called as a depth jumps. You can also do exercises like pogo jumps, you can do tuck jumps, and you can do squat jumps. So these are different variations, and you can you should start from the most easy variations to continue to a most difficult variations. Now, and as you train, you can shift from a two-legged plyometric to a single-leg plyometric. So single-leg jump from a height, so you can do a depth jump with a single-leg hop, or you can do a pogo jump or tuck jumps with a single leg. So as you progress in your training, you can progress with your plyometric training. But as I told you, always do this plyometric training under supervision. And I can summarize that it is a proven technique to increase your performance in competitive sports. So it's a good method, but always try to do it under supervision, and always be slow and progressive. So start your plyometrics sequentially, not at a time. If you have any doubts regarding plyometric training, you can write us on the comment box. Thanks a lot.